Okay, friends. Hi, this is Chris with Josephine's Design. This is an unintended part two. So, either I was extremely long-winded, but somebody had unplugged my camera, and it hadn't been charging. So, no problem. My youngest daughter figured it out. She's brilliant. So, okay, so here is this particular pad. I'm just going to go back. I was explaining how much I love this. I love the colors. So, I'll just start over with it in case I missed this part. I don't know where the last one ended. So, Christmas trees. Beautiful tags. I will totally use this in an album, in my Christmas albums. I love more beautiful tags. Seriously, you could buy one of these pads and make all your Christmas cards, and they would still be homemade. So, I mean, you didn't stamp, but hey, that's okay. And you don't have to be square on these. You could use your die cuts, cut out circles. You could corner round. You could be like special round. You know how we have those beautiful corner punches. So anyways, long story short, beautiful. Oh gosh, I love that. Isn't that gorgeous? Oh my goodness. And ooh, I love that for background. See, they're getting so good at these. Oh, I love these for the, if you're doing scrapbook pages or even on your cards, you can cut strips and put them down the side, put them on the bottom where it says Merry Christmas. The deer, the birds, let it snow. Absolutely gorgeous. Love that background. Snowflakes on gray. Ooh, white Christmas trees on green. Look at that foil. Those are stars and snowflakes. They're gold foil. Oh, that's a pretty poinsettia. Let me make sure I didn't skip anything. Beautiful, rich cranberry poinsettias. Oh, that's so cute with the moose and the white Christmas trees. That is so cute. Love that color. So rich. Ooh, love the wood grain. Another neutral background. Another green holly leaf neutral background. I mean, these are a lot that you can build. So these would be your mats, or you could do your card out of this. It would be your card base. Oh, I love that plaid. And I would never pick that plaid, but I like it in this set. And I love that. That is beautiful. Oh my gosh. Love that. That's so gorgeous. Oh, and that's another beautiful neutral. It has the snowflakes and poinsettias and stars. Oh, and here are the words. Merry Christmas, rejoice, hope, winter, wonderland, love, good tidings, season's greetings, love, North Pole, that's what that was, sleigh bells, happy holidays, joyous Noel, joyous Noel, let it snow, joy to the world, angels. Beautiful. Look at that. The moose, the deer, the birds, the trees, the snowflakes. Beautiful. And another neutral snowflake on gray this time. Oh, I love that. That doesn't have to be Christmassy. Well, it could be winter. That's gorgeous. And it has foiling. The berries are silver foiled. They're kind of hard to see. I hope you can see them. Beautiful. And of course, red birds. Gorgeous gold foiling. Holly leaves, snowflakes. Oh, that's beautiful. Now, I would have foiled those berries, too, again. But still beautiful. Yep. And actually, that may be where you go back in with your Winkostella and just sit there and tap it. Or you could use even, like, stickles. So beautiful. All right. Beautiful. Okay, that is my Michaels haul. Now, one thing I'm going to show you guys. Oh, I forgot. So, we were there, and the manager was there, and I think they were giving these to everybody, but I'm not sure. She knew that I had lost a family member and that we were having a difficult time, and which is really sad when they know you at Michael's and it's the manager, they know your story. But long story short, she gave me this cute little Santa, and I'm not thinking it had to be for everybody. More I thought about it later. But it's a 2017 Santa. I thought he was so beautiful. And, And so, I mean, he was regularly $14.99 at Michael's. But isn't he beautiful with his velvet and his boots and everything? So he's going to sit on my craft area because that just brought me joy. And it was such a blessing and such a sweet gesture. And it probably, they did it for everybody, and I didn't know. But it made me feel very blessed that night because it had been a hard day Thanksgiving. First Thanksgiving without our family member and the other one not doing well. So, you know how that kind of went down. And the plans that we had got completely changed. And it's okay. We bloomed where we were planted. We had Thanksgiving on Saturday. We enjoyed it. So anyways, I had all my kids with me. How could we not love it? And I ordered these from Amazon. So if you guys haven't seen the Crayola calligraphy, I think that's what they call it. I can't remember. But I've seen lots of people on YouTube, and they are doing brush lettering with these super tip markers. And here's all the colors that you get. And I'm going to try to open this. I thought it would open easy, but, you know, why would it do that? And I'm going to show you guys what is in the kit. And I hope I can open it easy. I have to call for my backup team here. Let's see. It's an interesting design on a box. I guess it works, except for if you have arthritis. Let me see if I can do it this way. No, I don't have a letter opener. If I had a letter opener in here, it would totally work, and I don't have one, but I think we can use the scissors, maybe. Anyway, so I thought I would give this a try. I know that was scary what I did with the scissors. And see how I liked them. These would be a great tool if you teach. If you have a ladies' night and you didn't want to put out your outrageously expensive, you know, pins crafting night, these are very affordable. And I know that they even have like a 50 set at Target of the same ones, and I wanted the 100. Finally, huh? But so here are the colors there. Look at that. Isn't that just gorgeous? It's just so beautiful. And I'll pull this out so you can see. It's a very interesting tip, and I can totally see how you can do brush lettering with that, because I did calligraphy early on with calligraphy markers like 30 years ago, and kind of self-taught, and before we had Pinterest, before we had any online goodies, and I have gotten away from that, and with arthritis, my handwriting's gotten worse over the years, and so I have signed up for a class with Boberry, and I finally was able to like even get to the link last night. I stayed up late looking at some things, and that's a friend of ours was talking about those goals, those three anchors in your life, and crafting is my fourth. And so, I mean, my family, you know, God, my family, and then my health, my exercise, which my diet, my exercise, that kind of goes together, my health, and then crafting. And so anyways, part of crafting, I think, you know, when you're writing, you're using your lettering, I think that is a beautiful personal style and a personal form of your art. And my handwriting is horrible. And I love Carrie Boberry, and she's been so sweet through this chaos in our life. And I want to practice that. And so I wanted to try. I got all the ones she suggested, and then I bought some of these too. So anyways, I thought I would apply it everywhere. Okay, guys, this has been two extremely long videos, but I'm only going to go one more thing, and then I'm going to make a separate video. So I signed up for, oh no, I already did this one. I'm sorry. I already shared that with you guys. I already made a video of that. So, let's see. I think I'll just go with these. Now, you know what? How about I just let you guys go? I'll do these in a separate video. All right, guys. Love you guys. Merry Christmas. It's all coming. It's going to be a lovely holiday, no matter what happens. And I mean that. And, you know, we may have another funeral. That's real for us. That is really real for us on a daily basis. But I recognize that it is God's timing in everything. And again, we give Him praise in the good and the bad. And I need to get my anchors back in place in my life, and I need to get focused again. And this lovely, lovely family friend said today, he said, how can you help others if you aren't taking care of yourself? And he said, no wonder you're worn out. No wonder you're exhausted. No wonder these things have been, you know, the littlest things kind of, you know, tip your day. You know, it's the straw that broke the camel's back. And, you know, once you kind of step back, you get perspective. And so, anyways, and one of my siblings and their spouse sent me a message, and they'd hoped that I had tranquility in the day, because they know that my day's very chaotic with caring for the family member. And I realized I'm not bringing them the joy completely that I want to bring them if I'm not, you know, settled in my heart. And of course, the minute you say that, Satan's going to try to mess you up. But that's okay, because my God is bigger than that, and He can handle it. And I know this is a terrible cliche thing to say, but He's got my back. He's got your back. Just trust Him. I'm trusting Him. My favorite verse is Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord in all you do. And I combine versions, so please don't fuss at me on the comments. My husband always gets on me. But trust in the Lord trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not unto your own understandings in all your things. Oh, I'm blanking out. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto your own understandings. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will direct your paths. So, yes, I'm tired. Can you tell? But it's a good tired. I stayed up last night putting things in place for me to be fed spiritually, physically, you know, health-wise, emotionally, you know, and craft-wise, and family-wise, and all those good things. And that's a win-win. That is a blessing, and I am thrilled with that blessing. And somehow when I woke up today, I was tired, yes, but I wasn't as tired as I anticipated I would be. So, being in an emotional spin, or on the treadmill, or the hamster wheel, whatever you want to say, it's exhausting. So it was time to get off. It was time to get off the treadmill. And I'm sure I'll hop back on, but I'm just going to have to hop back off and pay attention to that. So, all right, guys, I hope this blessed you. Please forgive my personal thoughts in all of this. I hope you enjoyed all the hauls. Again, from part one and part two, we have Amazon, Michaels, and Target Dollar Spot. So if you missed the part one of this, please go back and see part one. I hope you'll enjoy it. And again, I'm sorry that my camera faded on me, but you know, that's okay. It gives you guys a break in between to go grab you a cup of hot tea or hot coffee, whatever you like. So, all right, guys, most importantly, thank you so much for all of your love and prayers and encouragement. I cannot say that enough. I know I say it every time, but I mean it. You guys have propped me up with all your prayers, with all your encouragements, and that's what this channel's about. So if you're not subscribed, join in, be encouraged, be loved, be a part of it. I cannot tell you what an amazing community this is. We are small, but we are mighty, and it is just a blessing to be here and to be a part of this. So thank you guys, and if you like this particular couple of videos, give them a thumbs up. You may put in the comments, like the hauls, not all the chatter, so that's totally fine too. And just say it in love, as I would tell my children and family members. If you're upset, just say it in love. And but I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate the feedback. And now, most importantly, I close all my videos with, I hope your day is blessed. I hope it is creative, and I hope it is ever so lovely. And I thank you for so much for stopping by. And I'll be talking to y'all soon. Y'all take care. Bye-bye.